गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द लेक्चर ऑफ रियल एनालिसिस 2. इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद द डेफिनेशन ऑफ अ मेजरेबल फंक्शन. लेट अस जस्ट रिकॉल द डेफिनेशन. द मेजरेबल फंक्शन इज एन एक्सटेंडेड रियल वैल्यू फंक्शन वेयर द डोमेन इज मेजरेबल एंड इट सैटिस्फाइज वन ऑफ द फोर स्टेटमेंट्स इन द अबव प्रीपोजिशन. लेट अस चेक व्हाट्स द प्रपोजिशन ऑल्सो. दिस इज द प्रपोजिशन वी हैव प्रूव्ड फॉर एन एक्सटेंडेड रियल वैल्यू फंक्शन. द फॉलोइंग फोर स्टेटमेंट्स आर equivalent, that is for each real number alpha the set collection of all x in the domain such that
ma'am notepad ki screen pe set nahi hai.
screen is not visible.
yes ma'am.
okay, let me just stop it and again let me share. Now check.
Yes, ma'am. No, it is visible.
Visible, no? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, for each real number alpha, the set collection of all x in the domain such that f of x greater than alpha, greater equal alpha, less than or equals to alpha, measurable, and we have proved step by step all these four statements are equivalent. Therefore, the measurable function says that it's an extended real value function defined on a measurable set E, defined on measurable set E, and one of the set is measurable, that is x in E, such that f of x greater than alpha, greater equal alpha, less than or equals to alpha is measurable. Okay, we have seen one proposition on this, that is if a function is measurable, then it is asked us to prove that collection of all x such that this is equal to f of x equal to alpha is measurable. Actually, we have proved two types of sets to be measurable, that is f of x greater equal by alpha and less equal by alpha. If I take the intersection, surely it is going to give us the set collection of all x such that f of x equal to alpha is measurable. This is also we have proved. Then we have seen the examples. In the first example, we have taken this function f defined on closed interval 0 to 1 to R star. R star is an extended real value function. Here, this example I have discussed in detail. Lot of time I have spent on this example where the values of alpha was taken in stages. In the first stage, the value of alpha we have taken less than or equals to 1. Therefore, the collection of the corresponding elements in the domain will be empty set. Actually, that is no element in the domain having the function value less than or equals to 1. Then later the value of alpha is taken from 1 to 3, then 3 to 5, and next it is greater equal by 5. These are the possibilities we have studied. And in every possibility, whatever is the subset of the domain, we were getting satisfying the restriction f of x less than or equals to alpha is a measurable set. That's why this function f defined is measurable. Similarly, we have taken the example of an exponential function also. Now here the another definition we have used, collection of all x in the domain such that f of x is greater equal by alpha. Now we have taken two values of alpha, two cases of alpha, say alpha less than or equals to 1 and alpha greater than 1. In both the cases, whichever the intervals we were obtaining are measurable. This is what an example I have given you for homework. Now let us come to today's lecture. In today's lecture, we were going to study some operations on the measurable function. Let me write the proposition. In this proposition, we were considering two measurable functions f and g, and we were going to prove addition by a constant, multiplication by a constant, addition of two measurable functions, subtraction of two measurable functions, and multiplication of two measurable functions is also measurable, right? Let us prove this. Let me write the proposition. Let f and g be the measurable functions defined on same domain. Why it is we were taking on the same domain? Because we were following the operations between the two, and in order to have the operation between the two functions, we should have the same domain, right? Defined on same domain, then prove that the functions f plus c, f plus g minus f and f dot g are also measurable where c is any constant means it's a number, it's a real number rather. C is any constant. Let us prove all these steps one by one, right? Therefore, we will follow the first step in order to prove a function f plus c is measurable. According to the definition of measurable function, what we want? The function should be defined on a measurable set. Now, if f is a measurable function, means the domain of the function f must be measurable. Therefore, what about f plus c? How f plus c has been defined? Can anyone tell me? Yes? How this function f plus c is defined? Hello, students. Am I audible to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
उत्तर का देते नहीं तुम्ही लोग का? What is given? F and G are measurable functions defined on same domain. Now, in the first step, we will prove that the function f plus c is measurable. We will prove f plus c is measurable. But for this, we should. Okay, I have written wrong spelling here. Measurable, but before that we should know how this f plus b, f plus c is defined. Therefore, may I define this f plus c? F plus c operated on x is actually f of x plus c for all x in given domain. Is it okay to everyone? This is a translation function simply. This is the translation function. Okay, this is what a definition is. Now, if I wanted to prove this right side function is a measurable function, what kind of statement one should check? This must be defined on a measurable domain. Okay, now suppose here I'll write on the same domain D, where this is a measurable set for the sake of convenience. Okay. Now, if f is defined on a measurable domain D, then what about f plus c? May I say it is defined on the same domain D again? Therefore, one part of the definition gets verified. What remains to prove? This f plus c must satisfy one of the statement of the above preposition. Correct, na? Here, let me write f plus c is defined on measurable domain. Measurable domain. What is the symbol we have used? D is the symbol we have used. Now, what to check simply? F plus C measurable, that it is going to satisfy one of the condition. Now, as F is measurable, therefore it satisfies one of the statement of the above preposition. Right now, therefore, may I write for any alpha in R, may I say it will imply collection of all x such that f of x less than alpha is measurable? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, what I wanted to check for f of x plus c. Therefore, let us consider the set of the type collection of all x such that f plus c operated on x less than alpha. Okay, what kind of set I am checking? Function f plus c operated on x less than alpha. This kind of function I am checking. But we know this function is obtained by or written as x such that f of x plus c less than alpha. Right now, as per the definition. Now, may I write this set again as collection of all x such that f of x is less than alpha minus c? Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, if alpha and c both are the real number, what about alpha minus c?
Real number.
It's a real number, no doubt, right? Therefore, may I use the definition that f is measurable? Therefore, for any real number alpha minus c, collection of all x such that f of x less than this real number, this set must be measurable because f is measurable. Correct, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Therefore, shall I write since f is measurable, since f is measurable, it implies collection of all x such that f of x strictly less than alpha minus c is measurable. Is measurable. But what this is actually? Collection of all x such that f x less than alpha minus c is actually this set, no? Therefore, can I write this is imply collection of all x such that f plus c operated on x less than alpha is measurable. Then what about the function f plus c? May I say it is measurable now? Thus, f plus c is a measurable function. Yes? Understood this part? Really easy actually. Yes. Knowing f is measurable, we are writing simply f plus c is measurable. What is the next point to prove? Cf is measurable. Right now? We were going to use the same argument to prove CF is measurable. Let me write it as step number 2. What to prove? The function CF is measurable. Again, to prove this, one should know how it has been defined. Okay? Therefore, CF operated on X. Yes, can anyone tell me how it has been defined?
C into F of X.
C into f of x, and this is actually called as point-wise operations. This is called as point-wise operation. Okay. Now, let us check whether the function cf is measurable. No doubt the domain will be measurable because the domain of a function f is measurable. Okay. For now, I am going to consider the set collection of all x such that cf operated on x is strictly less than alpha. But this is nothing but collection of all x such that c into f of x less than alpha. C into f of x less than alpha, which equivalently says that this is a collection of all x such that f of x less than alpha by c. But here we will just make sure that c should not be 0. Okay, what happens if c is 0? If I take the constant c is 0, this is c into f, that is 0 into f, it will be a 0 function. This will be a 0 function. Therefore, we were just making sure that the constant need not be 0. Therefore, this is what a set is. But what about this alpha and c? As both these are the real numbers, what about alpha by c? Is it a real number?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, this alpha by c is a real number. But the function f is itself a measurable function. Therefore, what about this set?
Measurable.
Yes, measurable. It is a measurable set. This is a measurable set. What should I write? Since f is measurable, right? No? Since f is measurable rewrite the set x such that f of x less than alpha by c is measurable set. Is a measurable set. Okay. Therefore, what can I have a conclusion? May I say CF is measurable now? If you are having a problem, you can stop me and ask. Right? Okay. Therefore, this CF is become measurable function. What's the next point to prove? F plus G is measurable. Let us go to step number 3 to prove that F plus G is measurable. F plus G is measurable. Can we have the same conclusion as of step number 1 and step number 2? F of x less than alpha, collection of all x such that f of x less than alpha, collection of all x such that g of x is less than alpha, but whether it together gives you f plus g less than alpha? No, it is not, na, actually. It will be less than 2 alpha, f alpha plus alpha it is. Correct, no? Therefore, here
yes, ma'am.
we have to use some different argument, right? Here, let us start with again for any alpha in R. For any alpha in R, what kind of statement we want actually? Fx plus gx. Okay, I forget to tell you how this f plus g is defined. How this f plus g operated on x is defined? Is it f of x plus g? Good. F of x plus g of x. Therefore, for any alpha in R, if I wanted the term f plus g operated on x less than alpha, let me write stepwise. For any alpha in R, if I want this kind of collection f plus g operated on x less than alpha, therefore may I write this is actually f of x plus g of x less than alpha. Okay, here which in turn gives us f of x is strictly less than alpha minus g of x. F of x is strictly less than alpha minus g of x. Now what we were going to write, as this f and g both are the real valued function, therefore for a particular value of x in the domain, this is a real number, no? F of x is real number. Alpha is real number. What about alpha minus g of x? This is also a real number. So clearly, we have two real numbers here. F of x less than this alpha minus g of x. This is a real number. This is also a real number. Now, we were going to make use of the dense property of the real numbers. That is, between two real numbers, there exists one rational. And with the help of this rational number, we were going to write this as a countable union of the set. Okay. For writing a rational number between two real numbers, is the aim is only that the reason is only that all rationals are countable, right? Therefore, here I'm going to write there is a rational number R such that, what such that? F of x strictly less than R, strictly less than alpha minus g of x. What is the reason? Since between any two real numbers, there is a rational number. Okay. Therefore, whatever the set I wanted to consider, x, collection of all x such that this condition satisfies, now it is equivalent to collection of all x such that this, okay? Hence, let me write it to the next page. I wanted to find initially collection of all x such that f plus g operated on x is less than alpha. Now, which is equivalent to find collection of all x such that, what such that? F of x strictly less than or less than alpha minus g of x. F of x strictly less than or strictly less than alpha minus g of x. Okay. Now again, this set is imposed with two different restrictions. Two different restrictions. Therefore, we will write this set as the intersection of two different sets. How? Let us check. Collection of all x such that I will write only a condition f of x less than r, and I will write another set, collection of all x such that r less than alpha minus g of x. Now, what should I consider here in between? Whether it is intersection or
intersection?
Linear? Yes, it is intersection. Okay, this is the intersection. Okay, therefore, whatever is the set under the consideration, collection of all x such that f plus g operated on x less than alpha, now it becomes equivalent to these intersection of these two sets. But here I cannot write directly like this, because how many such R we have? I have written this for this inequality only. Okay. And what can I write for the this set, left hand side set now? Okay. I just wanted to write this as x less than f of x less than r less than alpha minus g of x. This is same. Okay. But now we were going to write it for collection of all x such that f plus g operated on x less than alpha. How many such r exist between these two real numbers? Okay, getting me what the correction I have done? F plus g operated on x less than alpha implies there is a rational number r such that it satisfies the condition. But how many such rational numbers do exist? There are infinite rational numbers, right? Therefore, if I wanted to collect a set of this type, collection of all x such that f of x less than r less than alpha minus g of x is nothing but intersection of these two sets. But if I wanted to write a set like this, I have to think of how many such rational numbers exist. Now we know there are such, how many such rationals exist? Infinite, rather countable rational numbers there exist. Therefore, finally, in order to write this set as collection of all x such that f of x less than alpha minus g of x, now if I wanted to insert a number r between these two real numbers, how many such r's are there? Countable r we have, right? Therefore, whatever the set we were going to write, whatever the set we were going to write as an intersection of these two, that is x such that f of x less than r intersection x such that r less than alpha minus g of x. Now we have to just think how many such r exist. There are countable r, and whatever the r exists, we will take all the unions. Therefore, here I will write r equals to 1 to infinity, or countable r one can say. Instead of writing r equals to 1 to infinity, I will write this is countable union only. Is the point clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, f plus g operated on x is this, but between this there exist many rational numbers. This set we have divided as an intersection of these two depending on that rational number, and as we have countable rational numbers between these two real numbers, therefore one can say that there is a union over such a R. So this is the set we have actually in our hand. Okay, now look at both the sets we have obtained. The first set is x such that f of x less than r. R is a rational number, means it's a real number, and since f is measurable, what should be a nature of this set? What should be a nature of this set? इज इट मेजरेबल सिन?
यस मैम,
करेक्ट ना, दिस इज मेजरेबल सिन. अगेन नाउ हियर वी हैव रिटन आर लेस देन अल्फा माइनस जी ऑफ एक्स, आर लेस देन अल्फा माइनस जी ऑफ एक्स विच इज इक्विवेलेंटली कैन बी रिटन एज, लेट मी राइट इट टू द नेक्स्ट लाइन. This is union over R, collection of all x such that f of x less than R, intersection collection of x such that. May I replace the condition by g of x less than, is it alpha minus R? Right? Okay, this set we have written already measurable. What about this kind of set, x? Collection of all x such as g of x is less than y number. This is also measurable. What about their intersection?
Measurable.
What about the countable union?
Measurable.
For may I say, finally, whatever the set we have considered, x such that f plus g operated on x less than alpha, what we have obtained? On the right side, there is a measurable set. Therefore, what about the measurability of the left-hand side? The set on the left is also a measurable set. Okay? Therefore, let me write simply, since F and G are measurable, functions, the sets, which sets? Collection of all X such that fx less than r and collection of all x such that g of x less than alpha minus r are measurable. Measurable what? Set or function? These are the measurable sets. Okay? And also intersection of measurable set is measurable. What about countable union? Countable union of measurable set is measurable. Why countable union of measurable set is measurable? I'm really surprised. Okay, the set on the right side we got measurable, therefore let me call it as statement number one. Therefore from one, may I say, from one, may I say the set x such that f plus g operated on x less than alpha is measurable, is measurable set. Therefore may I have a conclusion that f plus g is measurable function. F plus g is measurable function. Let me just repeat the concept. Okay, we have started initially with the argument f plus g operated on x less than alpha, which gives us fx plus gx less than alpha, which can be written as f of x less than alpha minus g of x. As these two are the real number, we were writing one rational number r in between the two for different values of alpha, for different values alpha and for different values of x as well. We get these two to be different real number, and for two different real number, we were getting different rational numbers in between the two real number. Therefore, for particularly, we say that there is a rational number between the two sets. Therefore, whatever the set under the consideration, f of x, collection of all x such that fx less than r minus g of x is written like this as an intersection, right? But if I wanted to write for this, we were going to have a countable union of all these intersections. What is the countable union? Countable union runs over R. Because for different values of x and alpha, such a different R exists. And for every R, we have to consider the intersection. And finally, we have to take their union so that we will get the required set. For if I am writing like this, this is actually whatever the two sets involved, these two sets are measurable. Intersection is also measurable. Countable union is also measurable. Therefore, the set defined on the right side of equation number one is measurable. Therefore, the left side is also measurable. And hence, we have proved that the function f plus g is a measurable function. If you have any difficulty, you can ask. No? What is the next point to prove then? G minus f or f minus g. Here can I write g minus f or f minus g are measurable. I think it is better to write f minus g, no? One can write anything. F minus g and f dot g are measurable. Therefore, let me write step number 4. What we were going to prove here, we were going to prove that f minus g is measurable. Before proving f minus g is measurable, what I wanted to prove is, as of we have proved, we know from step 1. What we have proved in step 1? Oh, sorry, not in 1, in 2 actually, CF. CF is measurable, we have proved, no? 1 or 2?
2.
Yes. 2 is, it's 2, right? Therefore, from step 2, we have proved CF is measurable. Therefore, now let me apply this for G function. Okay. Therefore, here, since G is measurable, may I have a multiplication to this G by a constant minus 1. Therefore, may I write minus 1 into g is measurable by step 2, right? Minus 1 a constant I have selected, minus 1 into g is measurable. Therefore, it tells that minus g is measurable. Okay, now what we wanted to have, we wanted to form f minus g. But we know f minus g is actually addition of f and minus g. Okay, now I'll write, since f and minus g are measurable, may I write this as f plus of minus g is also measurable. What is the reason?
Step third.
Yes, this is by step number 3. Okay. Now, what is f plus of minus g? F minus g is measurable. Okay. Hence, we have proved f minus g is measurable. What is the last point remains to prove? F dot g is measurable. Before proving f dot g is measurable, we will try to show that f square is measurable first. Okay, so this is the last step number 5 to prove that f dot g is measurable. Okay, I think everyone is knowing the fact a product of function f dot g, how can I write it in terms of the addition square of the functions? Because one may have a question why we were proving f square measurable first, right? No. To explain this, let me just tell you what is the square value of a function f plus g. How it is being evaluated? Is it f square plus g square minus 2fg? Right? No. Now we wanted to find fg. So let us shift everything on the left and tell me the value of f g. Yes? Is it f plus g bracket square minus f square minus g square? Right? And then further it is divided by plus 2 it is, no? Therefore it is plus half. Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Therefore this product now is being expressed as the square of f plus g and addition subtraction. Therefore, already we have proved the addition of two measurable functions is measurable. Therefore, once I prove that the square function is measurable, therefore all these three quantities will be measurable, and thus addition, subtraction, whatever is performed is also measurable, and multiplication by the scalar half is also measurable. Therefore, to prove the result f dot g is measurable, what we wanted to prove, first we show that, or we prove that. First, we prove that f square is measurable. F square is measurable. Now, to show that f square is measurable, what we wanted to start with? We wanted to start with the set collection of all x such satisfying one of the condition is a measurable set. Now, what I will do? I will write if alpha less than 0, then the set collection of all x such that f square of alpha greater than f square of x is greater than alpha. What will be this set?
Measurable.
How it is measurable? What is the set you should know first? For any alpha less than 0, say minus 1 I will take. Suppose I will take alpha is minus 1. Then what will be a set here? F square of x is greater than minus 1. But we know any quantity will not be negative. No? Any square quantity will not be negative. Therefore, greater than minus 1 is now equivalent to say greater equal by 0. Therefore, how many values of the domain will be there in this set? How many values of the domain is having square of x is greater than minus 1. All values.
Infinite.
All domain. Let me just repeat. What is f defined? F is defined on D to R star. Correct? D is the domain of a function. Now what about f square? F square will be defined on D to R star again. Right? Now we always know that f square of x is non-negative because it is a squared function. Now for any alpha alpha negative, we wanted to find here which value I have taken alpha minus 1. Therefore, may I say greater equal by 0 is equivalent to or same having the value greater than minus 1 or greater than alpha for alpha less than 0. Therefore, how many values of the domain satisfies this condition? F square of alpha, f square of x is greater than alpha or rather greater equal by 0. All the elements from the domain will satisfy, no? D cha sagle elements jar apan ghetle tacha square kela or non negative term milnar hai na?
Yes, ma'am.
It means greater equal by 0 and which is surely greater than by a negative number, which is surely greater than by a negative number. Alpha is less than 0. Therefore, what is the set actually? This is world domain. Okay. And what about this set? Is measurable set, no? Why measurable? Is measurable set. Why? Since f is measurable. I hope you are getting me. Let me repeat. For alpha less than 0, we wanted to find out the collection of the set, collection of elements x such that f square of x is greater than alpha. What is alpha we have selected? Negative. What is alpha we have selected? Negative. Therefore, we wanted to find out the elements in the domain satisfying this condition. F square of x is greater than alpha, alpha negative. Therefore, if I take this condition, if I take this value, say alpha, okay, therefore may I say f square of x is actually greater or equal by 0, one can write greater than minus 1 as well. And for how many values of x, we get this condition, f square of x is greater or equal by 0, for all the elements in the domain, no? If this gives me a domain set, and this domain is measurable because f is measurable function. Okay. Similarly, if alpha is greater equal by 0, then let me consider the same set collection of all x such that f square x is greater than alpha. F square x is greater than alpha. Whenever I am writing f square of x is greater than alpha, taking square root, what about f of x? What about f of x?
Greater than square root of alpha.
Is it plus minus square root alpha? Right, no?
Yes, ma'am.
This is plus minus square root alpha. Therefore, whatever is the set, now it can be written as collection of all x such that f of x greater than plus root alpha union with collection of all x such that f of x greater than minus root alpha. Is it okay? Hello, students.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now what about this set? Measurable or not? Alpha real number, root alpha is a real number, f is a measurable function. Therefore, collection of all x such that f of x greater than root alpha is measurable. This is also measurable. Right now, this is, I think you have understood why this is union, because this is plus root alpha or minus root alpha. No? If it is and, then we were taking intersection. As it is or, I have taken union. Okay, this is a measurable set, right? Because f is measurable. What about f of x greater than something, some real number? Measurable. What about their union?
Measurable.
Measurable.
Therefore, may I say the set is measurable. Here, let me write, since f is measurable, the above two sets, are measurable. And union of measurable set is measurable. Therefore, may I write collection of all x such that f square of x is greater than alpha for alpha non-negative is measurable set. Is a measurable set. Now two equations we have to take in consideration. This is one, for alpha less than or 0, the set is measurable. Similarly, for alpha greater equal by 0 also the set is measurable. Therefore, from 1 and 2, collection x such that f square of x is greater than alpha is measurable set. Is measurable set. What it will imply? The function f square is measurable. Okay? The function f square is measurable function. And what I have to write finally? Product I have to write now. F of finally. May I write f dot g is half times into bracket f plus g bracket square minus f square minus g square, as of we have discussed here, right? No, if I just take square f plus g, it will give you f square plus g square plus 2fg, which in turn gives us this value, right? Now just check out, let us use all the previous steps we have proved in order to check the measurability of f dot g. what if f and g are measurable, what about the addition?
Measurable.
What about the square of measurable?
Measurable.
Measurable, right? What about this f square? Measurable. If g is measurable, g square is also measurable. What about the subtraction of the two measurable functions? Measurable.
Measurable.
Again, the subtraction of two measurable function, measurable. What about a multiplication by a constant half? Measurable.
Measurable.
Right. Therefore, finally, we were getting right hand side is measurable. Therefore, the left hand side f dot g is also measurable. Therefore, here I'll write simply, since f plus g bracket square, f square, g square are measurable, comma, the sum and difference and which term we have to use? Multiplication by constant, no? Are also measurable. Hence, may I write f dot g is measurable. Yes, if you have any difficulty up to this, you can ask me. F dot g is measurable. How many operations we have proved to be measurable? Addition by constant, multiplication by constant, addition, difference, and product, and also square. All these operations of measurable functions we have proved to be measurable. Okay. Let me go for our next function to check the measurability. Okay. The first function under the consideration is a step function. Step function. Now we wanted to check the measurability of this step function. But before going to check the measurability, let us write the definition. What is the definition of a measurable function? See, a function psi defined on closed interval AB to R is called step function. If there is a partition, I think all of you are familiar with the word partition now. A equals to x naught, yes. x1 to xn equal to b of the interval, say AB, okay, such that in every subinterval, open subinterval, xk minus 1 to xk, the function psi is constant. That is, psi of x is defined to be ck, constant c, for all x in the open interval xk minus 1 to xk, and how much the k runs from 1 to n. Let us give the example of the step function. What is the step function example? A simple example I will give you. F defined on closed interval A to B to R, okay, and it is defined as, say, f of x is equal to alpha if A less than or equals to x less than c, and is equal to beta if c c less than or equals to x less than or equals to b. Let us try to draw the graph for this function and we will check whether it is a step function. According to the definition, first a partition should be made of the given interval, and for every partition the function is going to take a constant value. Okay, now here how the partition defined? Yes, how many parts of the given interval is being made? Suppose somewhere here is the value alpha and somewhere here is say beta. Okay, now the interval under the consideration is A to B. Therefore, let me mark the point A to B somewhere here. C is the point in between selected. Therefore, how many sub-intervals we have made of the original interval? Two sub-intervals. No? Therefore, this is a partition actually. Okay, and the function is defined to be, the function is defined to be alpha from A to C, including A, excluding C. The function is alpha. Okay, if it is not exactly C, just previous to C. This is what a value is. And what about the next value? It's including C to including B, the value of a function is beta. Right? Okay, this is what a graph of your function. And if you can check, this is a step function. You are looking at steps. I think while teaching Riemann integration problem, we have taken one step function also. Do you remember 1 upon 2 raised to n something is the example?
Yes, ma'am.
In that, we have taken the step. I have shown you many steps also. Therefore, this is a step function. Why the name is step function? If you can check the function or the graph of the function, look like it is steps of the of some building, right? Now it is some steps, right? This is a step function, right? Let me write one more example of a step function. The famous example is a signum function. Have you heard the word signum function? I think we are out of the time now. I'll just define this. Signum function is defined as s of x is equal to 1, is equal to 0, is equal to minus 1 for x greater than 0, x equal to 0, x less than 0. What will be a graph? This is a step function. What would be a graph? For x equal to 0, the value is 0. For x greater than 0, the value is 1. If I mark this as 1, this will be, right? Okay. And if I mark this as minus 1, somewhere here. Okay, this is plus 1 I am marking. For x equal to 0, the value is 0. And here I am marking, say, minus 1. For all x less than 0, that is to the left hand side, the value is minus 1. For all x greater than 0, the value is plus 1. This is called as a signum function, and no doubt this is a step function. Okay, many more examples are there actually of the step function. One more is a greatest integer function. Okay, look at this greatest integer function. And also we wanted to deal with a characteristic function. Therefore, I am giving you today a homework to see the definition of characteristic function. Also, you must see the definitions of limit superior of a function, limit inferior. Lim sup, lim in, I think you have heard these words. You just recall those concepts, because after step and characteristic function, we were going for measurability of limit superior of a function, limit inferior of a function also. Okay. Time being, let me stop for today. If you have any difficulties, you can ask me. Yes, students, if you have any difficulties in about today's lecture, you can ask. Otherwise, let me stop it here. Yes, have a difficulty or not? It seems there are no difficulties. Let me stop for today. Thank you for being with me for this lecture.